Coffee and text in the morning. Breakfast in bed, I be moaning. Good afternoon, everyone. This is your sister, Sinette Inter, Angela. Hope that you all are having a beautiful Saturday, enjoying the cool, breezy, sunny day. It's beautiful here. Wanted to come forth and just do a brief share. But first, let's address the elephant in the window, if you don't see it, or the room, rather. If you don't see it, I do. I have done something different and drastic to my hair. I did cut off all of my dreads. Yes, I did. And I do feel relief. I'm happy about it. I feel liberated. But yet still, I physically feel the imbalance of it. And I don't like it, the feeling of feeling imbalanced, but it's okay. I know it will level out soon, but I definitely feel that imbalance. My body knows that something is different. And your hair is a part of you. So you are your hair, but it doesn't make you. I just decided that, you know, it was thinning some, it was growing some, and I just wanted to just get rid of it. So I did. Well, right now I haven't decided if I'm going to grow it back. I'm having it covered most of the time now because I haven't been to a beautician or a barber to basically shave it down, shape it up, or whatever I wish to do with it. I have cut it down very, very low, just about to my scalp, and it's okay, but it doesn't look neat enough, I feel, to reveal it. So I think I cut it last Sunday or something like that, and I didn't really think about it. It's just, I just decided, took the scissors, and it was just time, you know, just how I am. Sometimes I can be very impromptu. Most of the time I'm very impromptu. I don't plan and prepare a lot of things, even though I can. But sometimes the best decisions are made when you're not planning for it. So that's what I did. I know that I have the option to wear wraps, get it colored, grow it out, shortcut, you know, perm, more dreads, braids, cornrows, wigs, sew-ins, etc. I know all of that, but what I'm thinking is that I'm just basically just gonna cut or shave it down and just have it as that. Well, anyway, that's addressing the elephant in the room. If you don't see it, I want to make sure that you saw it, so it's done. But what I wanted to talk about now is talking about the shift that we in. A major time and a fantastic time to be alive, to witness right now. And that's basically the changing of the planet, the evolution of the planet, what we're in the middle of right now. We think that we are in the midst, or we believe that we are in the midst of what we call in this virus situation. And yes, to some extent it is real, and I've addressed that before, and I won't go further into it right at this moment. But something else is happening as well. Some can be to our advantage and some to our disadvantage. But what I believe is that we are becoming and highly more computerized, highly more artificial intelligence. I had a dream long time ago, and I wanted to talk about it then, but I didn't know how it would be received until now, and I still don't know how it'd be received. But basically, it was that humans turned into computerized. They were highly digitalized. And I made a post, was it a couple of days ago? And some of my posts I leave up, and some of them I just take down right away. And I just leave it up for maybe an hour or two. But basically what this, I don't remember it word by word, verbatim. But basically what it said is that God created humans. And we use the word, I'm outside a bit, a little bit. We use the word God loosely. Because as I mentioned before, of course I believe there is a superior being, but the word God is a word that's human made. Basically, God, as we defined it or have defined it, is creator. And we all create things, right? So that's not, you know, belittling anyone that uses the word God or the superior being or universal God, as we call it, because we don't understand God, and that's, you know, how we explain it, you know, God. But it's much more than that. But anyway, that was a side bit. Let me start over again from this post. I said, God created humans, and humans created artificial intelligence, AI. Or has AI come back to reveal that they were really the real gods? And we as humans are about to discover who the real God of artificial intelligence of. You know, I said something along that line. But anyway, I have it in my notes, but I don't remember it verbatim. But that's the gist of it. But yes, what if artificial intelligence was already here? And we have de-evolutionize ourselves down to not knowing about artificial intelligence. Just something really that I've thought about, and I had this dream, and you know, sometimes I don't remember my dreams right away, but throughout the day, or things can spark, or a thought can really spark. It's like, yes, I did dream that. But anyway, I feel that we are definitely headed towards a very highly computerized age, the age of Aquarius, the age of witnessing a lot of miraculous things that we don't remember that has happened before. And I know certain places on the planet are highly digitalized, highly computerized right now, and other parts of the world are trying to mimic that, and perhaps they will, because it's basically for us all if we choose to accept it. Myself, I've seen a lot of different articles. I've seen on YouTube a lot of people talking about this chip situation and being tracked and known. And then what I've even thought when I was a little girl was that if you were born, you were if they wanted to track you, you were already tracked, really. And you don't really have to have a chip to have that to happen. But a lot of people are talking about these vaccines and these chips and being monitored and all of this interesting stuff. But, you know, I wouldn't necessarily want a vaccine or being chipped either. But sometimes these types of things we have no control of if we choose not to. But in my opinion, like I said, if they wanted to monitor us, it's already done, really. However, the control mechanism of that, I'm not sure how that's going to work. There's been various themes and ideas as to what would happen if this world was really chipped, different people having this chip situation. I'm not sure. Or some people call it the mark of the beast. I'm not sure if that's going to be revealed or happen or not. I'm not sure. It'll be interesting to see. I don't feel that it's something that we really have to worry about right now. I do feel that there are people with sinister or highly evil intentions for mankind. Yes, I do believe that. But as far as a chip for monitoring or controlling people, I'm not sure of, you know, at this time. I myself, you know, I have not witnessed or seen any manifestations of anyone wanting to harbor intentions of me being monitored or asking to be chipped so that, you know, my everyday life can be manipulated and controlled. I'm not sure. I'm not interested, of course. I'm not volunteering, of course, and I don't want it to happen for myself or anyone else as well. But what I do know is that we are in the midst of watching evolve a different world than we've had for even the last 10 years that we can remember. And I embrace the change. However, I am not condoning anyone vaccinating me. I'm not in the middle of wanting to be chipped so that I can be volunteered to be monitored. I feel that it's an abomination for that to happen to any animal or any human being at this time. And I just wanted to come forth just to share that, not, you know, spreading any fear or anything like that, but just a thought and just watching to see what evolves with the human and what we believe will happen, what we allow to happen, and what we believe to happen. Anyway, that's it for now. That's my little share for now. Something to think about, just addressing myself and my change as I evolved. And just also watching and experiencing this great time to be alive and to witness. We read in history books, whether it's correct or not correct, things that went down in history. And this is the opportunity to watch and document and write your own story and not just listen for the his story and the her story or the I story, but you can witness it and document it, you know, for yourself. It's a great time to be alive. Don't stand in fear of anything. Right now, the only thing that I am not battling or anything like that, but I'm concerned about is, you know, this feeling of imbalance with, you know, cutting my hair or, you know, with my workplace. I have to wear this mask all the time. It's mandated or I wouldn't wear it. But as I mentioned to everybody, and I keep mentioning, and I'll mention it again, these masks, surgical masks, protects everybody from you. It offers no protection for you whatsoever. But do what you feel is right. Do what is mandated. I am not trying to start an evolution, because what I found out is that you start an evolution alone, you know, a revolution, you start it alone. And you don't really have a lot of help, at least on my end anyway. And I know a lot of people are out there. A lot of people are fighting a good fight and doing that. It's just myself, I'm not doing that, but I am documenting and I am sharing. And if it happens to help, if it sparks an interest or understanding or congruence, or if there's any information that anyone else have, I welcome that as well. But anyway, thanks for visiting the city, and I hope that you all have a beautiful Saturday. Take care.
They say morning, what do about it, good, babe? Clearly you agree, don't be trying to leave. Stay here with me, I'll put you right back to sleep. I get you right for the week. We can vacay in the sheets, set you for lay in the pain. I need to wake up, soon as we wake up. Wish we could lay up.